Hi, I'm Allie Sealander with UTD GeoNews, and I'm here to tell you about a strong earthquake that shook Western Nevada recently. It was a magnitude 6.5 and occurred early in the morning on May 15, 2020, near the small town of Tonopah, right next to the border of California and Nevada, and about 200 miles northwest of Las Vegas. The state of Nevada is a beautiful mountainous desert. In size, it is the 7th largest U.S. state, but ranks 32nd in terms of population. Geologically, Nevada is known for its mineral resources, like gold and silver, and recreationally, it's world famous for the various games of chance that go on the Vegas Strip. Nevada lies within the Great Basin, or what geologists call the Basin and Range Province. This was a pretty big earthquake, with more than 15,000 people reporting to the U.S. Geological Survey that they had felt it. Although small earthquakes are common in the area, a big one like this hasn't been felt in Nevada in 66 years. It occurred in an active earthquake belt called the Walker Lane. This is a system of faults about 60 miles wide and nearly 500 miles long, and is sometimes called the Eastern California Shear Zone. Shearing is a type of stress that doesn't push the land together or pull it apart, but instead slides two sides past each other, either to the left or to the right. This is also called strike slip faulting. The movement of the Walker Lane faulting system allows California to move north relative to Nevada at a rate of about 1 inch per year. Walker Lane marks the western edge of the Basin and Range Province. Just to the west lies the mountain wall of the Sierra Nevadas. The Walker Lane has a general north-northwest to south-southeast trend, but about halfway down the lane, we see a sharp bend, or deflection, to the east, where it becomes a left lateral shear zone characterized by east-northeast to west-southwest oriented faults. This is called the Mina deflection, and it is where our magnitude 6.5 earthquake occurred. The Mina deflection is a fascinating area, and fortunately for us, UT Dallas had a team out there for several years studying these faults. The work done by Dr. Nick Mueller and Dr. Scott Kerstetter, in addition to others, has revealed a lot of information about the faults in this area. These studies reveal a lot of young, active east-northeast and north-northwest faults along the Mina deflection and Central Walker Lane, which may be related to the May 15, 2020 earthquake. Just like these other faults, the May 15th earthquake was caused by left lateral motion on an east-northeast and west-southwest trending fault. When a strong, shallow earthquake like the one that hit Nevada occurs, some uplift or subsidence of Earth's surface takes place. An interesting way to see this displacement is by using something called an interferogram made by satellite radar. The European Space Agency satellite, Sentinel 1B, bounces radar with a wavelength of 5.5 centimeters, or about 2 inches, constantly off the Earth's surface. We can see how much the Earth moved around the earthquake by comparing radar reflections gathered by the satellite before and after the earthquake. This radar interferogram, made by Professor Tim Dixon and graduate student Taha Chorsi at the University of South Florida, shows these changes in a very colorful way. Each cycle of the color wheel, from purple to purple, indicates where the surface moved either toward or away from the satellite by half of the radar's wavelength, or 2.25 centimeters. This allowed the USF geoscientists to make a map of where the Earth moved due to this earthquake. Notice that the region covered is 50 kilometers, or 30 miles across, and the region that moved the most is about 10 kilometers across. Just to the west of the earthquake epicenter is where we see the most displacement, with a difference of about 15 centimeters, or 6 inches down. So keep an eye on the Walker Lane and the Mina deflection, and don't forget to check out our other GeoNews episodes. Also, consider subscribing so you don't miss the next one. I'm Allie Sealander, and I'll see you later.